Hey guys, coming to you from the Museum of Transportation here in St. Louis, Missouri. And once again, I'm back to give you a look at this 1966 Union Pacific Rotary Snowplow. And today, we're actually going to get the opportunity to take a look inside. And so we'll be back in just a minute to give you a look. All right, guys, you've been asking to see the inside of this Rotary Snowplow for a while now. And the curator from the museum here was nice enough to open it up so we could take a look around. And I don't know the most about this, obviously, but I'll show you around. And I've got your various buttons and controls. And, you can see the little emergency brake valve there. And it says ice pick, up and down for pressure, and then the flanger. Kind of interesting. And just got a bench seat up front here for the operator. And you can see the various gauges. It's got a fuel gauge, the plow load meter in amps, brake cylinder, brake pipe, it says. And then you have the plow tack. It'll let you know the RPM that that's running at. And I think they typically can run it at about 150 RPM. You got the amps here on this gauge as well. That's the pusher load meter. And then this right here is your throttle. And you can see they got a little graduated scale there, up to 8. And then this little switch down here, it says throw right, throw left. And basically that chute can pivot. And you can see right now it's throwing off to the right. And but that can swing over and then throw it in the opposite direction. And that's what that lever does. You can see they've just got metal grating here on the floor. And then they've got kind of a matching control center over here with the same flanger gauge and ice pick. And then your various controls for flanger up and down, ice pick up and down. And then they've got a control box here for the left windshield, the main windshield, and the right windshield. And presumably that's to defrost those or de-ice them. And, that's pretty neat. And then it does have windshield wipers even on the side windows, because obviously you're gonna have a lot of snow being thrown around. And up here, let's see, you've actually got a speedometer. It goes up to 70 miles an hour there. And, looks like some sort of heat sink here. But pretty interesting. And here, let me just give you a little view out the front windshield so you can see what you would see from the driver's seat here. And then in the back of the cab, they have another bench seat for people that can ride along. And let me give you a view out the door here so you can see the kind of, I don't know if you can get an idea of the depth here, but we're about 9 feet off of the ground to the floor level. So it sits up here a pretty good ways, obviously. All right, guys, we're gonna go ahead and take a walk down back here and take a look at the diesel engine they have in here. It's pretty cool. You can see it's just got metal grating on the floor everywhere, so it's a, you know, high traction surface and everything. And you got a series of various valves and everything. And you got your gauges so you can keep track of how everything's running. Take a look at it here. And it's got the, you know, everywhere around here they have these little plaques that have like the various operating instructions to kind of make it as easy as they can. And, here's another set of gauges for the pressure going into the filters, engine oil, and oil pressure, everything like that. Very cool. And as you can imagine, this engine is massive, as you can see. Very cool. And I believe, I'll have to check the specs again, but I believe it's in the neighborhood of 3,000 or 3,600 horsepower. And of course on these, that only powers the rotary blades up front. This is not self-powered, it's actually pushed by a number of locomotives. And very interesting. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look around the other side here. Let's see. I don't know how much room we have, but we can kind of take a look at the engine here. But I thought you guys would like a look around the inside, because it is pretty cool, that's for sure. And not too many people have had the chance to look inside one of these. But anyway, guys, we're going to go ahead and head back outside. Alright guys, I thought that was pretty cool that they let us up inside there to take a look around. It's definitely something that most people don't get a chance to see. But while I'm here, I thought I'd also show you that they've actually been completing some restoration work on it. So we'll take a look at the progress. And then when they've got it all complete, I'll come back and give you another look as well. You can see they've painted those guards in safety yellow. And then they've also repainted the blades as well. And those are looking much better. Very cool. And let me back up a bit. We'll take a look down the side here. Once again, the entire outside of this is stainless steel. And what they've been doing lately is shining up all that stainless steel. The problem they had is up top, there's some steel grating that you could walk on up there, and with it being steel, it does rust. And then over time, that rust will run down the stainless steel and streak it like you see up there. And so what they've done is they've begun cleaning all that off on the lower section here. And of course, they're going to continue on and shine up the whole side here. And then they're also going to take some preventative measures by actually coating the steel up top so that this doesn't happen again. So it's definitely going to be looking sharp. We'll go ahead and take a look down the side here, and you can see the little measurement marks they have here. And like I said, it's 9 feet just up to the floor of the cabin up there. And then over here you can see it's over 12 feet to the top of that chute up there by the blades. So it's definitely a massive machine. Very cool. And you can see the windshield wipers on the windows of the cabin there. Very nice. And they've even completed some painting down below. So that's looking really sharp as well. Very nice. And one of the things that I kind of missed in my last video is this little plow that they've got built in down below here. You know, obviously, even though you got the rotary blades throwing the snow out up front, you're still going through deep snow, and it could have a tendency to pack up underneath, and this will actually help clear all that out from down below. Definitely a good idea. But you can see obviously the work they've done so far is already looking nice. He said when they've got it all cleaned up, they're also going to repaint these letters, so that'll be pretty impressive. Since we're here, we'll go ahead and take a look at the specs again. Like I said, 1966 Union Pacific. This is the heaviest of its type, 367,000 pounds. And those blades can turn up to 150 RPM. And once again, the 3,000 horsepower turbo diesel that's inside this only turns the blades. It is not self-powered. It would be pushed by, you know, up to 3 or 4 locomotives. And so definitely a very impressive machine. Here we'll go ahead and continue out back here. You can see some of the painting they've been doing down there. Very nice. And we can take a look at some of the decals and everything they have here. Very cool. And the coupler they have out back. But definitely a very impressive machine. And I know it seems like you have a lot of interest in it as well. Anyway guys, I just thought I'd give you another look at it and show you some of the progress they're making on it. And I just thought it was really cool of them to let us up inside there to take a look around. So anyway, if you get a chance, come out to the Museum of Transportation and check it out for yourself. Thanks for watching and commenting and everything, and I'll see you later. Bye.